the question that I would like us to all go out and ponder tonight in the coming days and weeks is this. Do my words, my thoughts, and my actions line up with the beautiful texts that I'm singing or facilitating singing for? What do my words and actions outside the church walls tell other people about God and about the Catholic faith? For example, is God truly my shepherd in whom I shall not want, because of whom I shall not want? Or am I anxious and fearful and exercising control over my world instead of trusting God and building up impenetrable walls of security because I don't trust God? Am I taking out my fears and anxieties on other people through anger because I can't control? Thanks. Do I actually see that the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord, as it says in Psalm 33? What does that mean about how I interact with creation? We're in a world where we talk about sustainability, but we don't always recognize the ways in which we're kind of cavalier about how we use our resources. Do I look for ways to conserve, to reduce consumption, to care for the earth that God gave us to be stewards of? Do I pick up trash? Have I ever considered bringing home recyclable silverware and trays from the fast food restaurant, because otherwise they're going to go into the landfill? Have I ever thought, hey, I can go out of my way and do this small thing to care for the earth? Have I ever actually thought about, like, do I leave my car running while I look at my phone? Well, do I sit there and leave my car running while the kids are in their piano lesson or whatever? How can I be more intentional? Do I actually believe that whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me? And how does that color the way that I approach all of the big and divisive issues of the day? When my coworkers and family members and online friends and opponents see me, can they truly tell that I am Christian by my love? Where's the place that we're the most likely to see violations of love these days? Anyone? Online. Yes. Online. I have a lot to say about that. Sorry. Do I approach my online interactions thoughtfully? Am I capable of listening to others and hearing and addressing what they're actually saying? Do I respond with an eye toward the human dignity and the pain that many people are sharing when they say things that anger me? Do I see in them the face of Jesus? And do I speak to them? Do I write my responses as if I am speaking to Jesus? I can't control what anyone else does, but I do have the control over that myself. Do I take time to form my opinions by going for in-depth analysis that I can measure against the teachings of the church? Or do I just knee-jerk share whatever made me angry without really fact-checking? Do I analyze things? Do I read the church documents? I know, they're really deep and long, and they use a lot of words, but there's a lot of really amazing things in there, which is why I've been mining the documents for quotes for Intentional Catholic, because they really do speak to the real world. I pose all of these questions tonight in the context of a music ministry night because I want us to consider the many ways in which our faith touches these mundane moments of life. There really is no area where it doesn't touch. All the ways that we can be more intentional about living our Catholic faith. Because we bring all of those things into the church doors with us on Saturday nights and Sunday mornings. The good, the bad,